Since the founding of this beautiful campus, some 135 years ago, many people have frequented these lawns, these classrooms, and these halls. There are many interesting creatures to observe here, but none quite so fascinating as the boys of 6C. Over the past year, we have been collecting information on these boys and have invited several experts to aid us in the understanding of these incredible creatures.
Of this species are particularly interesting for multiple reasons. For one, despite having a diverse range of athletic backgrounds, they have decided to form a cult around one specific sport of their choosing, i.e. anything that involves a disc. To be in this sport requires a special initiation, so I took it upon myself to perform a sort of case study in which I associate closely with one member of the mod. I chose the one that seemed most apt to feminine engagement.
While most are illiterate, some can teach themselves to read and many appear to study at odd hours. However, it is likely they simply are drawn by the scents released by old books, which resembles that of the outdoors they so enjoy.
We've noticed some interesting behaviors from these boys as well. If we were to compare them to an animal, we would say they most resemble cats. They find locations that they like to inhabit.
You get stuck in the normalcy of everyday life.
And often they will rearrange furniture to make this possible. Some of the leggier ones will intentionally take up more space to assert their dominance over certain areas. We've also noticed that they really enjoy outdoor games, if you will. We have a theory about this. We think it might make them feel a little closer connected to the earth from which they crawled out of. We've observed them in a variety of situations in which they're throwing these round discs across campus or just running and throwing their weight around the green. And we think that this is a bonding experience for them and that it's something that truly makes their existence and presence on this campus very unique.
This means their methods of communicating are often unorthodox.
On this chilly winter evening, we discovered something outside of our door that is relative to the culture of these boys. We're not sure what it might be, but we think that it could be a peace offering for our particular group. As you can see, the artifact has been carefully crafted with much love and dedication, and it really would be a shame for us to throw out such a piece of work. They're really interesting to observe, but their behaviors are often concerning or possibly dangerous from the point of view of observers who don't know or understand their way of communicating.
It's called Oh My God.
Where'd it go? Where'd the water go?
What the water do?
What that water do? What that freshman stone do?
To be honest, I'm scared of them.
Hammer time.
No!
It's a little unbalanced.
Next four, wait.
Our investigation requires further work, but so far, what we've concluded is this. They work as a collective of terrible judgment, and they are valuable parts of Bethel College's delicate ecosystem.
Join us for our next episode, where we will investigate the mating practices of this unique and fascinating species.
Have you guys ever slipped on an actual banana peel?
No. Is that all you wanted to say?